Rhebenezer. One December morning, Nancy came to the sheds. She polished Rheneas's brass as the little engine was readied for work. "You must be excited," she remarked. "Your first Christmas home since being mended. It's a call for celebration."
"No time for that," smiled Rheneas. "Far too much to do."
"Surely," replied Nancy, "you must be having some sort of party."
"Surely not," chuckled Rheneas.
"Railways don't stop for Christmas parties, my dear. We've managed just fine without them."
"You've never had one?" cried Nancy.
Scarlowe yawned, woken by the discourse. "You must understand, Nancy, we weren't in a position to have parties in the old days. Our crews went home to their families, thankful for another year of work. Rheneas and I were just glad to have rails beneath our wheels."
"Well, those days aren't these days," retorted Nancy, "and you shouldn't carry on like they are. Stop being a pair of old ladies and have some fun. Why, my choir group could come sing for you later."
"My timetable doesn't have fun scheduled today, but it does have a train in 20 minutes.
"Thank you for the polish, Nancy," whistled Rheneas, as he steamed away. "Honestly, Scarlowe, how do we get him to lighten up? You've had plenty of Christmas parties before."
"Not that he's been here for," chuckled the old engine. "Give him time. He'll come around." He didn't. Any party talk was lost in the sound of whistles and leashes. The other engines grew nervous.
"There's been a party every year since we arrived," said Peter Sam.
"Imagine saving the railway only to squander Christmas," puffed Duncan.
"The big railway has them," added Rusty. "Why can't we?"
"Precisely," said Sir Handel, "and I'll not be upstaged by them. Gordon will go on about it for ages."
Rheneas was none the wiser. He carried on, determined to run the line as he always had. That afternoon, he'd slipped fiercely on a section of rail. He got his grip just as he passed Rusty and the workmen.
"What do you think, Rheneas?"
Rusty was gazing at a small pine tree, damaged by winter winds. The workmen had stood it up like a Christmas tree.
"I think the rails back there need sanding. You'd best be off before the next train comes."
"Oh,"
Rusty sighed with a downcast look.
"I thought it was just our size."
At the top station, Nancy and the choir were practicing carols. Peter Sam decided to join in with his whistle. As he gave a punctual toot, there came a great screech. Everyone winced as Rheneas braked to a halt nearby.
"What's happening?" he cried.
"Oh, we just finished I Saw Three Ships," said Peter Sam.
"Oh, Holy Night is next, if you fancy whistling along."
"No, I don't. I thought you were in trouble."
"Come on, Rhebenezer," giggled Nancy. "How can we sing at your Christmas party without practicing first?"
"There won't be a Christmas party," he snapped. "I've already told you I don't want one. I'm far too busy, and so are you, Peter Sam. Now, if you'll excuse me, I have work to do."
He stormed off up the line, leaving a flustered Nancy behind.
"The quarry's the perfect place for a crabby old engine like you," she shouted.
Dusk fell as Rheneas shunted the last of his trucks together. He glanced around. Save for a few workmen, he was all alone. Just like the workshops. He remembered the holidays that passed during his repairs. The shops were deserted, save for a few engines who were indifferent to him. He thought of how lonely he'd felt, how he wished Scarlowe were there with him. Nancy's words echoed in his smoke box.
"Oh dear," he sighed, "I have been a crosspatch."
On his way home, he stopped at the top station to fetch his coaches.
As he shunted them, he noticed the station master decorating the tree in the waiting room. It did look nice. To his surprise, the choir was still there, singing happily.
Were we singing too loud for you, Rhebenezer?
I am sorry, Nancy, he sighed. I'd grown so used to not celebrating Christmas. I didn't stop to think if anyone else wanted to. Your choir does sound wonderful.
We've missed our show. The car meant to pick us up got stuck in the snow. But I'm glad it's made you change your tune, she smiled.
Still could put on a show, Nancy. At the sheds, the thin controller was hanging decorations. He glanced at the solemn faces around him.
What's gotten into you, engines? You'd hardly know Christmas was coming with how positively dismal you look.
Excuse me, sir, sighed Scarlowy, but it's...
It's Rheneas, bellowed Sir Henry.
I was getting to that, glared Scarlowy.
No! Look!
The echoes of Nancy's choir spilled out of the coaches as Rheneas arrived with a great whistle. Sorry we're late, he smiled. Had to make a few, special stops.
Our tree! Gasped Rusty.
From one of the trucks, the crew unloaded the tree Rusty had found earlier.
It really was just our size, laughed Rheneas. I'm sorry, Rusty. And everyone. I suppose I was caught up in old habits. I'm grateful to have a railway to call home, and to be with my friends again.
Does this mean, ventured Peter Sam, we are having a party?
On one condition, stressed Rheneas.
What's that?
Nancy must stop calling me Rhebenezer. The little engines all chortled with delight, and the festivities began. Rheneas smiled. It was nice to celebrate. Best of all, it was good to be home with friends new and old.